bad, so you always have to be really focused.
We are still driving on the CA13. We are going south. We drove from Santa Elena to Finca y Chobel. Now we're going to Rio Dulce and Morales, south. Our fear is not the road. The truck driver here are driving like crazy. They are driving really fast. It's scary sometimes.
They crash a lot. You read the news and the people say, be careful with the big truck because they are always crashing here. Making big messes.
And the people with motorcycle, they don't wear the helmet. Nobody wears helmet, so it's really scary.
I used to race with motorcycles, and I never go on my motorcycle without my helmet, gloves, and all the protections. It's really dangerous.
Really big trucks driving fast. And going on the opposite side of the road because they are trying to avoid potholes. Yes. They don't care about you, just...
to do a drone footage, but we cannot fly the drone with the rain.
I think now it's time to find a place where we can sleep.
Yeah, it's getting dark.
It's getting dark.
What
it's
time
five,
is it?
5 p.m.
So like about 6, it's already dark. So we have 1 hour to find a spot where to camp, where to overnight. And it's raining like crazy.
Is not working anymore.
Yeah, it stopped working.
After just 4 days?
Yes.
4 days.
Luca is really, really sad.
Yeah.
He wants the air conditioning so bad.
Especially for when it's raining, yeah. Otherwise you cannot. River. As you saw, was raining a lot, so we kept driving to get out of the rain. And one of the things that is not so nice about traveling like this is that sometimes to be safe you have to sleep in places where there is a lot of noise. As you can see here, it's full of trucks going around, a lot of noise, and we paid a security guard there 10 quetzales, it's $1.30, to he will stay here all night. He has like a big gun, and he said that he will take care of us, he will protect us, so it's perfect, but a little bit noisy. This is part of traveling. Sarah is cooking.
Hi everybody.
And probably there is a truck with a freezer, I don't know. He keeps doing like this with the engine. Really noisy. Really, really noisy. Come si chiama?
Rambutan.
Rambutan. Ed è dulce.
A dire bene, si lice di rambutan.
Lice.
Ah, lice.
Si rompe nuda.
Come se apre. Ah, sono i lici!
Ah,
lici! Buono! Dolce! 20, tieni un... Gracias!
Buoni?
The lichis here, they are... they have hair on it. But they are really good, really sweet.
Va bien.
Gracias!
Gracias!
Gracias, buenos días.
They are building the new road. They are making all the asphalt. They are paving. There is a lot of traffic, but they are making really a good road.
Guatemala City, they drive like crazy. I'm driving since this morning really early. I'm really focused. You have to be always 100% focused on driving, because it's really, really, the roads are crazy, people are crazy. We saw some accidents, so focus.
We arrived at Soledad after a long way from Morales. Luca is pretty tired.
Yeah, and we didn't have lunch. We are driving since this morning at 6 in the morning.
Yeah, we would like to skip Guatemala City because it was really a mess with the traffic and all the crazy drivers in the big city. Now we are at an altitude of 2,300 meters, and we met Catalino. He's one of the guides recommended on iOverlander. We weren't sure if we would like to go by ourselves to hike the Acatenango volcano, or to
pay a guide.
Yes, to pay a guide to come with us. Everyone said that it's really recommendable to go with a guide, especially because if you want to camp on the top. A lot of tours and a lot of people are going there, and it's almost impossible to find a spot where to camp if you are not with a guide. So now we are going, we are following Catalino to his home, to his house, and we will negotiate a price with him. We will see how much he is asking for the guide, because we have everything. We have the tent, we have all the gear, so actually we just need the guide to hike on the volcano. We are thinking to hike tomorrow. Now it's 3:10 p.m. so we have the time to just relax a little bit and take a nap, and edit a video, eat something, and be ready for tomorrow. The hike takes 5-6 hours to get on the top, and then we can spend the night at the top, and hopefully the weather will not be so bad. Probably will rain a little bit, and you see it's all covered with clouds. I don't know, we will do this and let's see how it goes.
Bien.
¿Bien?
Sí. ¿Bien o bien?
Bien.
¿Te gusta el camper?
Sí. Sí.
¿Mucho?
Sí.
¿O mucho?
Sí. Sí. Sí, sí. Eso es una ola de surfear.
Eso es un surf.
Surf.
Yo me siento. Pero puedes jugar cinco.
Correcto.
Tú puedes jugar cinco.
No, no lo sé.
¿Cómo es?
¿Te gusta aquí?
Sí.
¿Carla? ¿Y tú?
Pamela.
Carla y Pamela.
Mucho gusto. Hola, ¿y tú?
Te llamas Anthony Chile.
¿Listo?
¿Así no? Sí.
Ok. Italia.
¡Italia!
¡Canada! ¡Uno de Corea!
¿Cómo se llama este volcán?
¡Acatenango!
¿Ya se fue allí al volcán?
¡Sí!
¿Cuántas veces?
¡Una!
¡Cinco veces!
¡Una y una!
¿Cómo se llama el volcán?
¡Acatenango!
¡Hola!
Te van a esperar, te van a dar tu vuelta.
Francés, banana bread.
Sí.
Sí, somos de Italia, está muy similar con el español.
Sí,
sí.
Muchos hemos tenido aquí de Italia,
sí.
De España, de Argentina.
Sí.
De...
Gracias.
Ayer
gracias.
Tuvimos dos. Dos se llamaban Italia.
No. Sí, desde Italia.
Nosotros le decimos como el apellido de mis hijos es soy. Entonces le decimos otro. Yo soy de Italia. Sí, soy de Italia. Sí, Italia, viene de Italia y se llama Italia.
Oh. Sí. Bueno.
Ajá.
Pan de banana.
Gracias.
Muy bueno.
At the end we spoke with Catalino of Azoava, los amigos del volcán Acatenango, and we decided to go with a guide.
Yes, we will go probably with his son. He will guide us to the top of the volcano. Why? Because at the top of the volcano there are some camps, and if you don't have a guide, it's really hard to find a spot where to camp. And since we will be bringing all our stuff, we want to have a place where to camp, where to make some videos, take some photos.
It's not actually necessary to have a guide with you if you want to hike the Acatenango, but it's recommended. So we would like to support also the association of Azoava, and some local family here. So we are more than happy to pay for a guide. The entrance for the Vulcano Catenango is 50 quetzales each, so it's 100 quetzales. And we managed to pay the guide, because we don't need anything else, 150 quetzales.
Per person.
So we will pay in total 400 quetzales. That is really a good price, a really good deal.
We will leave also in iOverlander all this information, so everyone who will come here, they will check what...
And even in the description of this video, we will leave the contact of Catalino. So if you would like to book the guide or the entire tour, because they organize the entire tour as well. If you don't have the tent, if you don't want to bring with you all the stuff, the backpacks,
they can make a special they can make a special package where you don't have to think about anything. They will do everything for you. They have already some tents up there if you don't want to bring yours because it's heavy.
A short recap. Today we drove from Morales through Guatemala City and we arrived here. We are already at 2,300 meters altitude. The hike is in two steps. You will do two steps hike. Tomorrow we will start and we will reach the first campsite. We will sleep there and then on the next morning we will make breakfast and then we will reach the top of the volcano. It's really dangerous with this weather condition to sleep at the top because it could rain. If you have an emergency and you need to go down, it's better to stay at a lower altitude. So we reach the top 4,000 meters just the day after tomorrow. We have two backpacks and we will need to fit everything we need in these two backpacks. Luca has the biggest one, the Rook 50, so 50 liters. But what we have is really, really light. So let's go and see what we will bring with us.
Okay, so our tent is a Salewa and it's 2.1 kilos. 4 pounds and 10 ounces. Then we have the sleeping bags that are 850 grams each.
And the mattress?
And the mattress that are really, really light, probably 200 grams, 250 grams.
Then we will need to bring all the camera gear. So we will bring the drone, we will bring the camera, the tripod, the lenses.
We have to bring the food and at least 3 liters of water each.
Are you excited?
Yes, I'm excited to see if it fits everything.
No, you're not excited for the backpacks. If you're excited to hike the first volcano in your life.
Yes, of
and
course.
And from this volcano we will see the Volcano de Fuego. It's one of the most active volcano in the world, still active. Now it's time to eat. We'll see you tomorrow morning because we didn't eat all day long. We are starving. We need to prepare everything and then we need to rest. But see you tomorrow, guys.
Ciao.
Ciao.
Guarda, perché fai il video di me?
Italia!
Italia!